scientists ask a lot of questions about the world, like, why is the sky blue? Why do the leaves change colour in the fall?
Why do some species persist and others do not?
We're really naturally curious about what's happening in the world, and so we do research to try and answer these questions.
It started out as a very big, ambitious project to basically build the evolutionary tree, the timeline and the history for vascular land plants.
Plants are effectively the foundation for all terrestrial life. By inferring a timescale for evolution, we can better understand how plants managed to colonize Earth. It's only been very recently that such a project has even been possible.
We're at a really exciting and interesting point in scientific discovery where we've accumulated and collected and studied this massive amount of data about the biology of living plants, about the geological record, about the fossil record. And then the molecular revolution happened and we started collecting DNA evidence. And so one of our new challenges in science is how do we incorporate this vast amount of information that we've been collecting together?
These methods are fairly new. They've only been developing within the last 5 or 10 years. So this is really an opportunity to field test these methods to see how they behave on real data.
We figured we needed just kind of a short little study group to test our methods. And some new phylogenies, evolutionary trees, and data had been published for this group of ferns, the Moradiales. So we took this data set and we started working with it, coding up these fancy analyses to do it, and it turned out to be a very involved and much bigger task and project than we had anticipated.
The fundamental surprise is that we could do it. We definitely went through dark days of thinking that this was not going to be possible. This project is, from the beginning and till now, hugely ambitious. One set of results, which is arguably the set that the broader public will be most excited about, is the inferences that we're able to make about how evolution happened, when evolution happened, how it is that plants were able to colonize land, how plants were able to diversify, form forests, basically form the foundation for terrestrial life. There's another set of questions I think are also extremely interesting, although perhaps to a smaller community of people, which is how does one investigate questions like this? So in some ways, that result is even more exciting because it is building a toolkit, building capacity for people to better understand the natural world.
Understanding the history of life on Earth places us as humans within the broader context of what it means to live on planet Earth. To me, there's no more important piece of information than to understand the history of evolution and where we fit into it.
This helps us explain and understand how we influence the Earth, how we influence the environment, where we come from, and what the effects could be if we destroy everything around us.